64 Kid Retro Gaming Goodness. Hey, Bastish B here, and welcome to my coverage of the 2022 Portland Retro Gaming Expo. Join me and Audi of Limited Run Games and Digital Foundry as we check out the show and hunt for those elusive Commodore 64 and Atari Jaguar games. So let's head on over and start checking out the show. The two biggest halls were the vendor area and the arcade section, so let's start checking them out. And the first Commodore-related sighting. Tons of great soundtracks here. I found the 1980X soundtrack, which is absolutely awesome. And I love finding really obscure Sega stuff. Audi was showing his skills on Commando in the arcade. Heck of a lot better than I can do in that game. Lovely selection of Saturn games, but the crown jewel here was this Lethal Enforcers box set. Love this 80s style lounge they had set up. Super nostalgic. And we decided to head over to the Atari Age booth. They had every single new release set up on every single Atari system you could imagine. Audi was on the hunt for the Bitmap Brothers combo of Gods and Chaos Engine that had just been released on the Atari Jaguar. And he picked those up. And I happened to find Sword of the Samurai, a MicroPost DOS game that I don't actually have. And this hall, they're having a massive Tetris tournament going on. But it was time to get some lunch. Super hungry. Before heading back into the belly of the beast. Besides the big halls though, there were also other cool sites to check out, like the Sega Saturn Lounge. The Pac-Man Museum. And the Blockbuster section. And back to the Sega Saturn Lounge. Been a huge fan of this system. Made this section one of the highlights of the show for me. Look at this karaoke monstrosity. Die Hard Arcade, literally. An absolutely amazing Nights Into Dreams stand. This guy's playing Bulk Slash on the Virtual On controllers. Such a good game. And they had the Saturn Pluto prototype on display as well, plus a full set of US Sega Saturn games, which is an absolutely amazing thing to see. It blew my mind. And back to the Pac-Man Museum, which tells the complete history of Pac-Man with all the merchandise following the story. There's CK Munchkin, the infamous knockoff game on the Odyssey. This Pac-Man light bright anybody? And tons more merchandise. Love this original artwork section. Yeah, it's Turtles Tournament Fighter, the original cover. And they had a complete set of N64 North American games. Not my system of choice by any means, but it was still pretty impressive to see it all collected together. Yes, finally found it, a box full of Commodore 64 goodness. Oh yeah. And here are some of Audie's pickups. Video Speedway on the CDI, Chaos Engine on the Jaguar, Tag Team and Shinobi on the C64, Gods on the Jaguar, and this awesome shirt. Just some of his pickups from Saturday. He's a very happy man. But alas, all good things must come to an end. So let's go check out all the pickups I got from the show. Hey, Bastish B here. I'm finally back home, and I'm sure this is the part you all wanted to see. I'll show you all the pickups I found at the Portland Retro Gaming Expo. Okay, so first up is Macbeth. based on the William Shakespeare play. This is for the C64. This is the double cassette version. Can't believe I found a cassette game at a US convention. It's so obscure and rare to find that kind of thing. This has got the full William Shakespeare play of Macbeth in here too, double cassette. I'll post a photo on social media. Just check them out. I'll show you like details of what this actually looks like. This is like a graphic text adventure game kind of thing, and it's got the entire Shakespeare play into like an adventure version, so super weird. Next is a really cheap pickup. I found Ace Combat, the Japanese version, on the PS1. This is super cool because this was $1. $1. The guy had a bargain bin of just import games. If I wasn't catching a plane and going back to Canada and all that kind of thing, I would have like loaded up on these things. Next is another C64 pickup. This is called Six Gun Shootout by SSR. They make strategy games, if you're not aware of them. This is a really obscure game. I can't believe I found it. $10? Are you kidding me? I'm sure this goes for a lot more online. I haven't really looked. I don't really care either. But it's like a turn-based strategy game in typical old-style SSR kind of form. But you get to play out kind of the best Western kind of shootouts in history, like the OK Corral and stuff like that. And wow, C64 disc version. Super happy to have this one. This next pickup is super weird because it's probably not what you think it is. So here it is. This is Dracula by Psygnosis. I'm sure a lot of you guys have played this piece of trash. I've played it, obviously. Either the Sega CD or the Genesis, Mega Drive, or whatever version you played. You know, the side-scrolling platform game. Even though both of those are completely different games, they still like, you know, side-scrolling kind of things. Anyway, so I saw this. This is the DOS version. I saw Psygnosis. I thought, oh well, you know, that's the DOS version of that. And I flipped it over, and it's a first-person shooter. Based on the Dracula movie. It's such a weird combination. I've never seen that before. And obviously I had to get it. It was super cheap. Obviously nobody wants this trash, but I definitely do. Anyway, so first person Bram Stoker's Dracula. Yep, I got it. And next is one of two Laserdiscs I found there. Didn't expect to find Laserdiscs of all things. So this first one is Riding Bean. It's an anime from the 90s, early 90s. If you know anything about this, this is by Kenichi Sanada. He did Gunsmith Cats. This character, Bean, he's in the same universe as that series. And this is pristine. If you're not into anime and you know, it's not really your thing, definitely check out Riding Bean. You'll be pleasantly surprised. It's old school kind of anime. It's just quality. And next is a game I definitely did not expect to pick up. This is all Audie's fault. I picked up Kasumi Ninja on the Jaguar. I don't even own a Jaguar, so now I have to get one. But the thing that drew me to this one was because he was looking through the bin of Jaguar stuff, obviously, and I saw Ninja, obviously, so I had to investigate. But then I saw it was a fighting game using digitized graphics. That's like something I love. I love cheeseball digitized graphics or FMV. I'm a big sucker for that. And then I looked and, you know, there's a Scotsman. You can play a Scotsman in a kilt beating a dude up, digitized style. You know, how can you pass up that kind of thing? So I had to get Kasumi Ninja. I'm looking forward to play this on emulation to see how bad it really is, which I'm sure it's terrible. And then I'll decide whether I want to buy Jaguar or not. Next is another C64 game. This is called Karate Chop. I mean, is that possibly the worst name you've ever heard for a game? Look at this cover, it's absolute cheese. So for this game, I was very confused about this because the graphics on the back look vaguely familiar to me. Like a game I've played before, but I never owned. And it's kind of weird. I didn't know at the time at the convention what this was. I even like asked Audie, he'd never seen this before. But I looked up online, and this is actually the UK game called Snapdragon, which is a terrible game. It's a terrible fighting game. That's why it like seemed vaguely familiar to me, because I've played it before, but maybe for like 5 minutes back in 1986. So anyway, so this is the US version, so they changed it to Karate Chop. They always got to change the name, obviously. It happens like pretty much every single time. So yeah, I got this piece of trash, and I'm glad to add this into the collection. I mean, if anything, the cover is pretty cool. Next is the Epic console pickup. This is Final Fight CD for the Mega CD, the Japanese version. Man, I love this game, especially this version of this game. It has the best soundtrack for Final Fight, I think, out of anything. It's better than the arcade. The soundtrack to this version of Final Fight is like kind of the soundtrack to Final Fight for me anyway. It's just so good. Excellent conversion as well. Fantastic game. Don't need to say more about Final Fight. So this is one of two shirts I picked up from these dudes that were doing these old computer style shirts. These look super cool. Anyway, I got Rise of the Dragon. It's printed out in a kind of like a DOS EGA kind of look. And yeah, it's like an adventure game if you've never played Rise of the Dragon. I just love the look of that. And next is another C64 pickup. This is Sergeant Slaughter's Mat Wars. This is a wrestling game, and very cool to see this one. This is done by Beam Software, you know, the guys that did Rock and Wrestle and Where the Exploding Fist. So I've played this very briefly back in the 80s. I don't know where I played it. Must have been at a friend's house or somebody's copy of it. But I remember it being pretty good. I really want to like play this again. The graphics are excellent. And yeah, it's like such a vague memory of this game. So it's like almost like exploring it for the first time. This was a super cool pickup. This is a DOS game. This is Sword of the Samurai by Microprose. And yeah, this is like a big old like kind of strategy game. You know, taking on like the role of like a samurai, and it's kind of like defending the crown. It's strategy, action. It's got a little bit of everything, but you know, this is like classic Microprose. This box weighs an absolute ton. It's got, you know, the manuals and like 7,000 discs in here. And next is the other Laserdisc I found. This is Moonwalker, the Japanese Laserdisc release of the movie, the Wacko Jacko movie. And I got this because I absolutely love the games, and all of them. You know, the Genesis Mega Drive one, the platformer is awesome. The arcade game is fantastic. And I even like the old 8-bit and 16-bit computer one by US Gold, even though they're kind of funky. I like them as well. So yeah, the Japanese version, super bizarre. This was also cheap also. Can't believe I found that. And another C64 pickup. This is called Spell of Destruction. This is another one where I saw it. This is one of those album covers, by the way, which I absolutely love these things. They're epic. I saw this and I was like, I don't know what this game is. Like, you know, what is this? And then I flipped it over and you can see the graphics there. So this is the UK game Wizardry. Not the Certec Wizardry. This is another one. It's kind of, it's like an action dungeon crawler kind of thing. But yeah, so this is another one that they changed the name for the US release, I guess, and called it Spell of Destruction. And they got this very happy wizard dude. Looks like he's making like some potion to heal a sick child, yet it's got Spell of Destruction. Yeah, it's like such a weird cover. It makes no sense whatsoever. They should have just left it, you know, Wizardry. Maybe that conflicted with the license for Certec. Maybe that's why it was changed. I can only assume. But yeah, I actually like Wizardry, the UK version, released by The Edge. It's released by Mindscape in the US. I actually like that game. People are flip-floppy about it, whether it's good or not. And this is the other shirt that I picked up. This one is absolutely epic. This is Ultima, Warriors of Destiny. Look at that. It's like, you know, the title screen after this title comes up. This is the first part where the avatar goes through to the gate to go through to Britannia, whatever, you know. So it's got like, and it's even like, it's popped out a little bit. It's got that kind of cool feel to it. It's got the DOS look, you know, that kind of style.
super cool shirts those guys make. And this is another game that I know is pretty expensive. This I got for $10 as well from the same like bin that I found with the C64 stuff. This is crazy. This is The Sentry. Most of you guys probably know this game as The Sentinel. This is again the American version. They changed the name to The Sentry. Must have been, I don't know why. But anyway, Firebird release, $10. Unbelievable. This box looks like it's brand new, like it was made yesterday. Absolutely wonderful. This is the disc version, which is even more cooler than the good old cassette one that I'm used to playing. Super weird game. I can't even explain this game to you. It's made by Jeff Crammond. He made so many cool simulation games like racing, like Stunt Car Racer and that. And this final thing I wanted to show here, this was gifted to me by Audi. So this is, I'll try and explain it briefly. So as you can see, it says Super Turrican. This is a book that was made independently by a Japanese guy in Japan for the convention called Comiket. It's like an independent convention where they can showcase manga or games or pretty much anything you want. And this was, he printed this. This is like an ode to the Turrican series, really, in kind of a manga anime form. It's even got Rendering Ranger here at the end. Manfred Trends is classic. And this was limited to like 150 or so, and he asked one of his friends in Japan to please go pick up 3 copies of this, one for me, one for Audi himself and somebody else. So I'm pretty I'm taken back that I actually got this. I can't believe it. It's just super cool. Can't thank you enough. Amazing. A little bit of like kind of obscure Turrican history here. Even though it's just independent, doesn't matter. It's just a super cool thing to have. And this is just a quick little wrap up of what I thought of the show. It was amazing. It's probably the best retro gaming convention I've ever been to, and I've been to a lot. This one just had a cool vibe to it. It probably has more to do with the company I was with, which made it even cooler. Meeting Audi for the first time, even though we've collaborated on lots of videos. It was very cool. You know, go game hunting around the floor was such a lot of fun. I really enjoyed myself. Man, it was such a good time. I'd highly recommend any of you guys check it out. There's a lot of computer stuff there as well as console, obviously. Massive arcade section, which was amazing. The pinballs were, they had ones from like the 70s all the way up to like the modern stuff. So much fun. So much fun to play. I got to play Vectrex for the first time. Finally got to play that thing. So amazing. Man, those vector graphics. So cool. Also want to thank my wife for making this whole trip possible. I never thought I'd be able to go to this, but she somehow wrangled it together. So thank you so much. And I got a little clip here from Audi. He wanted to say something about the whole thing, and I'll hand it over to him.
Hey, Bastic. It was great seeing you at Portland. To everyone watching this, please like and subscribe to BastishB64K, and we'll see you next time. Cheers.
And that about wraps it up. Thanks for joining me, BastishB at 64K. I hope you had a good time. If you can, please like and subscribe. That'll be greatly appreciated. And I'll see you next time. Cheers.
That's for you.
Are you recording me?
Yeah.